government is currently examining the transparent disbursement of the $4.5 billion direct assistance, while at the same time providing support to those citizens who are severely affected due to the COVID-19 pandemic. These and other important matters related to oil and gas and more were addressed today by Vice President Honorable Dr. Bart Jagdeo during a media conference hosted at the Arthur Chong Conference Center.
Vice President Dr. Bart Jagdeo addressed the media this afternoon, this being his first media conference as Vice President. As he began, he spoke of the assessors who undertook a week of assessing the various ministries and government agencies. As he stated, in terms of the COVID-19 pandemic, he said, in his words, shocking state of disorganization found in the setup to combat COVID-19.
Frankly speaking, it was shocking about the state of disorganization and the lack of a clear strategy to address an existential issue for Guyana. And for those of you who saw what took place, you would recognize, for example, that the individuals were quick to give descriptive presentations about what is taking place, how many people have contracted the virus. And we said to them, we can read that in the newspapers. We want, because the newspapers and the media has been disseminating the information to the public, what we would like to get from you is to how to fix the problem. And what help do you need to fix the problem? So first of all, how many tests can you do per day? And they did not know what was the capability of the country and how many tests per day could be done.
The Vice President said that the structure in place was extremely political. He said there were no appropriate structures to address the pandemic at all.
So we said, how many testing kits do you have? We asked, and they had 2,000 testing kits. And in the entire country, because the private sector did not have any, and we said, well, if you have 2,000 testing kits and you have to get up to 350 tests per day, that's only 6 days of testing, and then we're out of testing kits. So we asked the gentleman from PAHO, how long would it take to get the kits in? And he said, 2 months additional kits. So in 6 days, we would have used up all of our kits if we're testing at the level they want to do, test that, and then it will take 2 months to get additional testing kits. So that was the state of affairs. And that is why I can relay to you or a ton of other issues that we found regard to the structures, etc. The structures were political in nature, extremely political. Harman's unit was made up mainly of politicians, not people to address medical or even people with socioeconomic experience to address the pandemic. Even the contact tracing and many of the people hired there were political people.
Before we tell you what else he addressed this afternoon, let's just quickly update you. 10,000 testing kits came from Barbados to Guyana. These are, of course, the COVID-19 test. There are 50,000 more testing kits on the way, and there are additional machines to conduct those testing. The Vice President also indicated that personnel are being trained to conduct the COVID-19 test as well, as the frontline workers have been overworked since the beginning of the pandemic here in Guyana.
So there was no appropriate structure apart from the procurement and material deficit. There wasn't the appropriate structure to address the pandemic. And then they had grave issues about capabilities for quarantining and as well as addressing a medical response, you know, emergency rooms, etc. And so that is what the president found, and he immediately said, we have to fix this. And so he started engaging the international community.
Even as the new government is just a week in office, the vice president says to expect the national budget in about 21 days. In terms of the economy, the vice president said that the contracts awarded through the national tender board to the regional tender boards are being fully investigated as well. In terms of the oil and gas sector, the vice president noted that His Excellency is key on local content policy. In terms of the environment, the president is also committed to having Exxon provide adequate provision for environmental protection. As he wound up his media conference this afternoon, the vice president noted that there is no witch hunting across the board. From the Artichon Conference Center with videographer Keon Blades, I'm Felicia Valenzuela, InfoHub.